Progress OpenEdge replication with replication sets enables high availability in two situations: in the case of the unexpected loss of a source database, and in the case of planned downtime. With replication sets, you have two target databases, a primary target and a secondary target, that you replicate to. Even when the source is offline, replication can continue between the targets. In this video, we will look at the unexpected loss of a source. When a source is lost, you transition the primary target to a new source. Once transition completes, database activity will take place on the new source and replicate to the other target. Next, you restore a database in the same location as the lost source. Then, you reintroduce the restored database as a target to the replication set. Finally, if you choose to, you can return the replication set to its original configuration. Let's see how this works. We have already implemented a replication set with three databases: the source database, DB0, the primary target, DB1, and the secondary target, DB2, all of which are running. We take a quick look at the database log to make sure that the databases are synchronized. Next, we shut down DB0 to simulate the loss of a source. We check the database log to confirm that the connection between the database is lost. Next, we run the command that will transition DB1 to a new source. Now, we start restoring a database on the primary machine that can be added as a target to our replication set. To do this, we create a new database by the same name, DB0, on the primary machine using a full backup of DB1. Next, we delete the previous DB0 files. Then, we enable after imaging on the new database. Finally, we enable DB0 as a replication target. Next, we reintroduce DB0 as a target to the replication set. To do this, we first start DB0 as a target, then we terminate the replication server on DB1, next we restart the replication server. This will add DB0 as a target to the replication set. We check the database log to confirm that. We see that DB0 is now synchronized with DB1. At this stage, the replication set once again has three databases, one source and two targets. If we want to, we can now return the replication set to its original configuration. You have now seen how OpenEdge replication works in the case of the unexpected loss of a source. To learn more about implementing OpenEdge replication, take the Implementing Progress OpenEdge Replication for High Availability course.